Hello and welcome back to the course of mechatronics. So in last video we have gone through the filters, right? So in last video we have gone through the one type of filter, that is passive filters. So we have studied passive low pass filter, passive high pass filter, passive band pass filter and passive band stop or band reject filter. So in this video we will be going through the next type, that is active filters. Okay, so before that we'll just go through what are the different limitations of a passive filters. Okay, we already know that passive filters are made up of the components like resistors, inductors and capacitors, and the main difference between passive and active is active filters are made up of op amps or transistors with resistors and capacitors. So basically we use active elements in active filters and the passive elements like resistors and capacitors are used in passive filters. So there are few limitations of a passive filters, like few are enlisted here, that is output of a passive filter will be always less than the input signal. Okay, as we know the input signal will be passing through the resistor and capacitor in case of a passive filter. So there may be a drop of the signal at the output. That is the limitation. Then if we try to cascade many such filters to design higher order filters, like we have already gone through band pass filters and band stop filters. So band pass filter is a combination of low pass and high pass. When we are going to connect a high pass filter and a low pass RC filter in series, we will get a band pass filter, that is a higher order filter. And again, if we connect RC low pass and RC high pass filters in parallel with an adder circuit, it will give us a band stop filter. So when we go for such higher order filters, output will be again even much lesser than the input. So that is again one limitation of a passive filter. And again, the cutoff frequency of such filters depend on the load value. That is we are going to connect load across the circuit, whatever the load will be present, it can affect the resistor available in the circuit, and that will again affect the cutoff frequency. As we know, the formula for cutoff frequency can be given as F is equal to 1 upon 2 pi RC. So where R and C, that is the value of resistor resistance R and value of capacitance of a capacitor C in farads. So again, it is going to affect the cutoff frequency. So these are a few limitations of a passive filter. So we can again nullify these limitations by using active filters. So advantages of active filters. So the limitations which we have seen for the passive filters can be rectified in active filters by using operational amplifiers. So obviously the limitations of passive filters can be overcome by using active filters. Very first point in this is active filters are not only selectively passes the certain band of frequency, that is which is required frequency band, like in for low pass filters low frequencies will be required, for high pass filters high frequencies will be required, for band pass filters certain bandwidth of frequencies will be required, and for band stop filters certain bandwidth of the frequencies to be rejected. So that certain band of frequencies it will pass through the filter, but also it will provide gain to the input signal. That is the main disadvantage of the or limit of the passive filter, is we will get output which will be less than the input signal. So here by using an operational amplifier in the circuit, we will be having some gain in the input signal at the output. So that is the advantage. Then again, operational amplifiers act as a buffer between load and the filter circuit. That is the third limitation, was the cutoff frequency can be get affected because of the whatever the load is connected in the circuit. So when we are going to connect operational amplifier in the circuit, what is going to happen? It will isolate the two things, that is the filter and the load, and because of that there will not be any effect of the load on the filter or resistor or a capacitor of the filter. So there will not be any effect on the cutoff frequency of the filter. So as op amp is going to act as a buffer, so that is again one of the limitation is overcome by using the op amp in the circuit, that is by making filters as an active filter. So we'll go through different active filters one by one. So first is that active low pass filter. So you can see here the circuit diagram is shown here. So here again, this is the low pass filter. If we consider up to here, circuit up to here only, that is this up to this dotted line. So this is nothing but it is again a RC low pass filter, that is passive filter as always. That is one resistance and one capacitor is connected here in the circuit. So here it is V in, and across these two lines we are going to get V out. Okay, so this is nothing but it is just a passive low pass filter. Again, the cutoff frequency is given by 1 upon 2 pi RC, where R is the resistance of this resistor and C is the capacitance of this capacitor in farads. So we will get the same circuit. What done here is we have added an operational amplifier here in the circuit, and again we know operational amplifier, this is an inverting terminal, this is non-inverting terminal, and here the output is short circuited in the inverting terminal and the non-inverting terminal is given the input. So this op amp here is going to act as a unity amplifier, or we can say it is acting here as a buffer. So what's going to happen here? So as it is a buffer, the gain will be 1. So whatever we can get V out here will be equal to V in for low frequencies, okay? As this is going to act as a regular low pass filter, so whatever the higher frequencies will be there, again reactance of this capacitor is coming into picture, and we know that reactance is inversely proportional with the frequency of the input signal. So if the frequency of the input signal is very high, reactance will be very low, that is it will not oppose current passing through the capacitor, and the circuit will be short circuited here. So the high frequencies will not be sent to the further part of the system. So basically the working will be the same, only what is going to happen here, it will be acting as a buffer or isolator, so that whatever load is connected here at these two terminals will not affect this resistor or capacitor or rather cutoff frequency here, as it is acting as a buffer, as we have short circuited the output with the inverting terminal. So gain will be 1 here. So whatever output we are going to get will be equal to V in. So V out will be V in this case. So again, as we know, the advantage of this circuit or adding the op amp is we'll have some gain in the output signal. So how that can be achieved? So the op amp can be used as input can be given to inverting or non-inverting. Any terminal we can give the input signal coming from this filter, no problem, but accordingly the gain is going to change, as we know here. So again, this is another circuit which is a little modified. What is done here is we have connected the input signal here in inverting terminal, and non-inverting terminal is grounded, and again little modification, instead of showing the capacitor here, it is added in the feedback loop. So if we are going to consider without considering this capacitor, this diagram or this circuit will become of simple inverting operational amplifier, okay, and the gain of this inverting amplifier, we know that it will be gain of the circuit will be again V out divided by V in, which will be again minus R2 by R1, okay, as it is connected in inverting terminal. So output will be out of phase by 180 degrees with input, and output upon input, that is gain of the op amp, will be R2 by R1. So values of these two resistances will give the gain of this amplifier. So if you connect the capacitor here, it will act as active low pass filter, okay, and that filtered signal will be supplied to this operational amplifier, and it will provide us output with gain of R2 by R1, ratio of R2 by R1, okay. Here again circuit is again modified because we have again added this capacitor. Instead of adding here in this circuit, it is again added in feedback loop, so that we need not add another buffer circuit here at the input to avoid any effect of the coming signal on cutoff frequency. That is the only reason we have added the capacitor here in the feedback loop. So it will again avoid that fluctuation of cutoff frequency, and whatever the cutoff frequency here we can get, it will be fc is equal to 1 upon 2 pi r1 into c. Okay, so r1 is the resistance and capacitance of this capacitor, c will be again used to calculate or used to design the filter. So again it will act in the same way, this resistor and capacitor pair will give us low frequencies to come out at the inverting terminal, and it will be again with gain given at the output. So this was regarding the active low pass filter. Then this is the diagram of active high pass filter. Again in this we can see here, again it is a simplified circuit. In active high pass, again we know that the capacitor is connected with series with the output, and resistance is connected in the parallel with the output for passive or RC high pass filter. Again we have modified here the diagram again, and again here what is done is the non-inverting, again it is connected to non-inverting terminal, inverting terminal, and non-inverting terminal is grounded. So here again whatever the input we are going to give to this circuit, as the capacitor is having its reactance, and reactance is inversely proportional to the frequency of the coming signal. Again if at the low frequencies the reactance will be very high, and because of that the capacitor will act as a open circuit, and there will not be any flow of the current through the capacitor, and at very high frequencies the reactance of this capacitor will be low, and it will allow the current to pass through the circuit, and the current the signal will be given to the inverting terminal of the operational amplifier. So again here the gain will be same, that is V out divided by V in will be equal to minus R2 divided by R1 will be the gain of this operational amplifier, and whatever the signal is sent to the inverting terminal will be given out with gain into V in. So this part here will act as a high pass filter, and this will be a operational amplifier for getting the gain. So basically here the whatever the high frequency signals will be available, that will be sent to output, and all the low frequency signals will be rejected. As again here FC will be calculated again by using these two components, that is 1 upon 2 pi R1 C here, R1 and C. Okay, so that is the cutoff frequency of active high pass filter. We are not going to go through the frequency responses again here, because the frequency responses will be same as we have gone through in the last video of that passive filters. The frequency response will be same in this case also, so we are not going to again repeat those things. For having an idea regarding the frequency responses, you can go through that video of passive filters, so you can get an idea regarding that. So again active band pass filter here, we have already discussed in the passive filters also that when we are going to connect two high pass filter and a low pass filter in series, we will get a band pass filter. Again in this diagram the same thing is done here. We can bifurcate the total circuit diagram of an active band pass filter in three different sections. First section is a high pass filter stage. So here you can see here it is a RC high pass filter which is connected to an amplifier here, and the input is given to here non-inverting terminal. Okay, and inverting terminal is grounded through a resistance, a feedback resistance and another resistance R3, and the output of this amplifier is given to an RC low pass filter here. Again this is the RC low pass filter, that is low pass filter stage is here. So whatever the signal is sent through this RC high pass filter will be again amplified here, and it will be sent to low pass filter, and it will again only pass certain frequencies according to the cutoff frequency. So this will act as an active band pass filter here. So we are going to provide input signal here, and it will be going through this C1 R1 circuit first to the amplifier, and then it will be sent to the C2 R2 circuit. And in this diagram, the same active bandpass filter is again shown, but what is done here is all the components are connected in such a way that the complexity of the circuit is a little bit minimized. Here again we can see here, here it is again, we have already gone through the two circuit diagrams of bandpass, low pass and high pass. Both diagrams are connected here in one diagram. We can see here the capacitor and the resistance, which we have seen in the active high pass filter, and the feedback capacitor, we have seen this is an active low pass filter. So again, this is the combination of those two, active high pass and active low pass filter in the same diagram. So here the capacitor is connected in parallel with the feedback resistor as it is shown in the low pass filter. And the resistors and capacitor C1 are connected here in series with connection of a non-inverting terminal here as shown in the active high pass filter. So it is just a combination of those two circuits. So it will pass certain band of frequencies to an output with a few with a gain of AV through this op amp. So this was regarding the active band pass filter, and the next is active band stop filter. So basically we have already discussed in low passive filters also. For band pass or band stop or band reject filter, we need to connect two circuits of low pass and high pass filter in parallel with an adder circuit. So we can add the outputs of two different filters, and that will be the output of a band stop filter. Here again, for active band stop filter, the same case is given. We can see here, this is the circuit for a active low pass circuit. So here it is again RC low pass filter with a buffer op amp. So here RLP, that is LP is for low pass, so resistance in a low pass and capacitor in a low pass circuit. So this is RC low pass filter, which is again, so the input signal is commonly given to these two sides. So one branch goes to the low pass filter here. Here again the frequency response is shown in very short manner, and this part is a high pass filter. Here the capacitor for HP is connected, and this grounded resistor, that is RHP, so it is HP for high pass. So V out of this is VHP, V high pass, and this is VLP. So this is the frequency response for low pass, this is the frequency response for high pass. So again the same case, this amplifier will act as a buffer here as well as here. So A1, A2 and A3 are three different operational amplifiers connected here. Here again the output of this low pass filter as well as this high pass filter is short circuited with the inverting terminal. So it will act as a buffer. So it will give us outputs, two different outputs. So whatever signal is sent, it will be sent to both the filters at the same time. So in this filter all the higher frequencies will be rejected, and in this filter all the lower frequencies will be rejected. Then those will pass to the next circuit through the resistance R. Again there is one another operational amplifier A3, which is a summing op amp. We have already studied the summing op amp also. In summing op amp, what happens, the output will be again gain into addition of all the inputs. So here it will be again addition of the inputs coming of the these two. So VLP plus VHP will be added here with gain. So V out will be equal to minus R divided by R, that is again if both the resistors are the same, so it will be VLP plus VHP. So V out will be gain A into VHP plus VLP. So this is an adder circuit here, or summing op amp, which is also called as a summing op amp or adder circuit. So we can use the combination of these three circuits to make a active band stop filter. Okay, so this is the thing, but it is a low pass filter, this is high pass filter, which are connected in parallel. Same input is given to the both filters at non-inverting terminals, and the output from both the op amps will be again connected to an inverting terminal of the third adder circuit, and we will get the frequency response like this. So this band between two frequencies, that is FCL and FCA, that is cutoff frequency for low pass and cutoff frequency for high pass, that band will be rejected and all other frequencies will be passed through output. So that is regarding the active band stop filter. So basically in this video what we have gone through is we have studied active low pass filter, active high pass filter, active band pass filter and active band stop filter. It was just introduction to these filters. We can go through the derivations of these filters for gains also, as we have used operational amplifiers here, so that can be done also, but it was just an introductory video, so we have not gone through in details here, so we can go through them one by one. Thank you.